Hi, I'm Otto Gottlieb. I'm an automation engineer at DMC, and I'd like to talk to you today about making dynamic screens with B&R Automation Studio.
The purpose of this video is to show how you can make an HMI page more dynamic by adding a pop-up to it. So the page that we're going to make more dynamic is the setup page. And the pop-up that we are going to add to it is coming from this common layers page called message box. It will ask if the user is sure that they want to open the screen. So in order to do that, you have to go to the layers tab of the setup screen, right-click and add layer reference. You select the message box and click OK. Now, right now it's on the screen, but it's at the very back, so we want to move it to the front. Therefore, you can right-click and select Move Down. Another option is to go to the Properties and modify Z order to be the highest number. Now, the message box is at the very front of the screen. I also changed the editable column from frozen to normal. If we look at the design of the setup screen now, you'll see the pop-up as the first thing on the screen. We want to have this pop-up appear as soon as you navigate to the screen in case the person doesn't actually want to be on the setup page. In order to do this, we need to set up the properties of the HMI so that we know what page the user is at all times in order for our logic to have an impact. So I set the change data point to the change page global variable, and I set the current data point as the current page global variable. Now I'm going to define some variables in the display so that I can use them in the code behind. One of the variables is called popup setup, which is an integer that will change the visibility of the popup message box. And the other variable is page setup, which is a constant with value of 60 corresponding to the setup page index. Going back to the message box pop-up screen, we can change the status data point in runtime to the variable that we just defined, which is the pop-up setup variable. When we set it to 0, this message box will be visible. When it's set to 1, then the message box will not be visible. In the display init code, we set pop-up setup equal to 1, making the message box invisible. And in display cyclic, whenever the current page is the setup page, we set the pop-up setup variable equal to 0, making the message box visible. Going back to the message box screen, we're going to set the properties of the yes button so that when the user clicks it, it will make the message box disappear. So we will set a data point, and that data point will be the pop-up setup variable, and we'll set it to 1. For the no button, we will set the action of its key to change the page, and it will change the page back to the main page so that if they're not sure they want to open the screen, they will simply go back to the main page. I hope you have found this tutorial helpful, and I hope you continue using B&R Automation Studio.